CHOPCHOP is a great tool for finding gRNAs that are both specific and efficient at cutting their target. It has a lot of options. You can click this. Here we're on the nuclease tab. You can select the PAM for your given nuclease. By default, it's for SpCas9 NGG. And importantly, by default, the efficiency of the cuts are calculated by the Donch algorithm, published in 2016. You're going to want to have that checked. John Donch and colleagues came up with a computer algorithm that predicts how likely a gRNA is to cut its target site, so how efficient it'll be at cutting its target site. They used data from over 4,000 guide RNAs to come up with this algorithm. It basically looks at the target site along with the bases around the target site to figure out protospacers that are very likely to be cut. Higher Cas9 cutting efficiency means more successful experiments and a happier time in the lab. There's also a primer tab under the options. CHOPCHOP will automatically design primers for you to analyze your mutations from CRISPR, or you can design the product size, the primer size, and the melting temperatures of the primers for analyzing your mutations. And then click Find Targets. And here you can see all the potential guide RNAs that CHOPCHOP has found in my gene, in the two exons that are in my gene. Actually found 293 guide RNAs, and they're ranked according to a number of criteria that CHOPCHOP uses. CHOPCHOP looks at their off-target effect. So here, MM0 means that how many other targets in the genome there are that have an exact match, that have no mismatches to your target. MM1 means how many other sequences in the genome have one mismatch, etc. It's probably okay to have guide RNAs that have a few mismatches, but it's not okay to have perfect matches in the genome to your guide RNA. CHOPCHOP also shows you the efficiency from the Donch algorithm, and so if you want to pick the guide RNAs that can both cut very efficiently and also don't cut a bunch of other things in the genome. It'd be useful also if you know other things about your gene. For example, what are the really important parts? CRISPR makes indels, which result in frame shifts. Earlier in a gene, closer to the end terminus, is more likely to give you a really massive change in your protein. However, it's important to consider whether that region is important for your protein. If the C terminus is highly important for your protein, a mutation would work there just as well. I'm going to select this top one here. You're going to see the guide RNA here, and you're going to see primers that would allow you to analyze that guide RNA. And you can see here, these are all primer pairs that you could order, and that would allow you to PCR this piece out so that you could get the sequence of this region and whether you had a change there or not. Next, you're going to want to see this video for easy ways to clone guide RNAs and other useful techniques.